I'd like to call the Roseville City Council meeting for October 8th, 2013 to order. Could rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, can I have a roll call, please?
Mayor Chirkin? Mayor Pro Temp Taylor?
Yes.
Councilman Ayudo?
Here.
Councilwoman Hagerty?
Here.
Councilwoman McCartney?
Here.
Councilman Shoemaker?
Here.
Councilman Swatowski?
Here.
Okay, I'd like to have a motion. Our Mayor John Chirkin was unable to make it tonight, so I need a motion to excuse Mayor Chirkin.
So moved. Support.
Motion and support. All in favor?
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion passed. Mayor Chirkin has been excused. Are there any items the council wishes to have removed from the consent agenda and placed on the consent agenda action items? If not, I'll need a motion to, we got approval of consent with the removal of item number 9, which would be the appointments. That's all I have.
It'd be item G, correct?
G. Okay. Okay, I'll need a motion for that.
So moved. Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty, supported by Councilwoman McCartney. All in favor?
Aye.
Anyone against? Any discussion? Okay, moving on. Hearing of the public? Hearing of the public, be the first hearing of the public. The hearings of the public are designated. Public comments on agenda items only will be heard at the first hearing. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address, address the chair. You are welcome to direct questions, input information, and or express opinions to the council. Anyone using inappropriate language, we call out of order, and we'll correct the language or leave the podium. Limit remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules will be called out of order by the chair. Anyone from the public wish to be heard by the city council? Agenda items only. Yes, sir.
What is an agenda item?
Yeah. Is this an agenda item? There's another hearing of the public after this on non-agenda items.
I guess maybe non-agenda items.
Okay. Okay, if not, we'll move into new business. I will have reports from administration and their departments. Madam Clerk, do we have any correspondence?
Yes, the absentee ballots for the November 5th election have gone out today. If you don't receive your ballot by next week, please contact the city clerk's office at 445-5443. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions for our Madam Clerk? Any reports of city manager, Mr. Atkins?
Yes, Mayor Pro Tem, council members, I have a few items for you this evening. First of all, some announcements from the library. Tuesday, October 15th, which is next Tuesday, the Roseville, it's the Roseville Historical and Genealogical Society will present Detroit's Corktown. It will be a presentation at the library's Aaron Auditorium at 6:30 p.m. Everyone is invited to attend and they will have refreshments. The library is reporting a technology update. You can now register to receive text messages when materials have been placed on hold and have arrived at the library. You can stop by the circulation desk to register your mobile phone number for this new high-tech service. We have several continuing construction projects. The sewer sanitary lining projects are continuing in the city at various locations, as well as the pavement and water patch program. Some saw cutting operations began yesterday, and we'll be working on the concrete replacement through the end of the month on those. As most of you may be aware, the large majority of I-94 construction has been substantially completed, and they've reopened all of the ramps as of yesterday. That will be slightly short-lived this weekend. There are some planned closures while pavement markings are put in place. So we have posted those on the city's Facebook page, and will be posted on the city website as well. But primarily, through the weekend, and this is Friday, October 11th through Monday the 14th, again, they will be putting down permanent placement of the pavement markings left lane of eastbound 696 ramp from eastbound 94 will be closed for a portion of that, and there will be intermittent single-lane closures on westbound 94 on Saturday and Sunday as well. Those will be marked by signboards ahead of time. So as they do the pavement across the ramp areas, some of those ramps will be closed. So again, we're posting that information as we receive it from the Department of Transportation. But after the markings are put in place, we should be finished with those construction projects. And then the last item I have, here at a recent meeting, we had a resident who had brought to the council's attention a concern with parking on Garfield Street in relationship to some of the businesses that are there. I'd like to report that Mr. Sexton and I, as well as the city attorney, have been discussing this item. And we did meet with Mr. Turi in person on site to discuss some of the concerns, as that seems to be the largest business there with the impact. I will tell you that we met, Mr. Sexton and I, in particular, on site with Mr. Turi on their day shift, which is their largest shift. On site at that time, everyone that was working there was parked on site. There were still available parking spaces for the employees as well as visitors. There were no truck issues with the loading or unloading, and there were no cars parked on the street. Mr. Turi did indicate that there has been a problem with the end of the day shift and the beginning of the afternoon shift. When people are still working, yet the next shift is coming in, and there has been a spillover onto Garfield Street on the west side, adjacent to the parking lot driveway areas. He's indicated that they are being proactive by sending out their supervisor, that as soon as the day shift employees leave, they're allowing their afternoon shift employees to come out, move their vehicles on site, and they're trying to facilitate that by supervisors actually making sure that that happens. He also has advised me that they picked up an additional building and parcel with the parking lot across from their location on Common that will accommodate about another 9 or 10 parking spaces, and we're also working with him to see if he may be able to acquire some additional property along Garfield for parking, and Mr. Tomlinson is involved in that. They are being very proactive. They understand the concerns of the neighbor, and we felt that we had a very productive meeting. I would suggest to the council that we may want to consider, though, looking at some type of traffic control order, perhaps, to limit the parking on the west side to a two-hour parking limit. That's one of the options we talked about. That may help facilitate the movement of vehicles from the street to the parking lot. And again, I am very confident in meeting with Mr. Turi and all of the conversations that we've had, that he is very mindful of the situation and very concerned about keeping the adjacent residential properties to not be impacted. So he is working with the city on trying to address this. And I will report that I was out there at 6 o'clock tonight. I wanted to go prior to the meeting. There were 7 cars that were parked on the street. There were open parking spaces in the parking lot. So I'm hoping that those people, again, were in that transition phase where they'll go out and they'll move those cars into the parking lot. But again, I think the council may want to have some thought. I expect no action tonight, but some thought, and we can discuss this at our next meeting, about a traffic control order for that west side parking that may also help movement. In addition, Mr. Tomlinson, Mr. Sexton, and I are going to be addressing 2 other businesses on that street, one that appears to be in compliance and not have any issues, and one that will have some code compliance issues, and we'll keep you updated on that. They're not any negative impact to traffic at this point, but we want to make sure that we keep up on those. So I will be sharing this information with Ms. Bartel, who had spoken to the council in letter form, and I've discussed that with Mr. Tomlinson, so we'll CC those copies so you have that. But again, we wish to thank Mr. Turi for his willingness to work with us, and again, I think he is aggressively working to try to resolve any outstanding issues. Also, he did report on a side note that they see good signs in the economy, and that they're looking forward to being back up to employment standards where they were before. So it's nice to have a business that's working well in the city. So I'd be glad to answer any questions you may have.
Are there any questions for Mr. Atkins? Councilman McCartney?
We will have that on the next agenda about the traffic ordinance.
We'll discuss it as part of our next workshop meeting, and then if the council wishes to have an action item, then we'll address that at most likely the October 22nd meeting.
That'd be a good idea.
I'd like to have Chief Berlin have his input as well.
For sure. Thank you.
Any other questions for City Manager? Councilman Ayuto.
Mr. Atkins, we we have a new style agenda at tonight's meeting. I wonder if maybe you could tell the public the change and what to expect going forward so they're there's no confusion.
Sure. As everyone has probably noticed in the first few minutes of the meeting, it is a little bit different. What we're going with now is what's known as a consent agenda. And a consent agenda is basically used to dispense of the non-debatable, non-action required items as far as any type of council deliberation or generally public input. So these are the minutes, the disbursement payment of the bills, resolutions or proclamations that are not being received by someone in person. Often we're providing a resolution in support or in opposition to maybe a position on a state bill. Those type of items would be under the consent agenda, which will be at the beginning of the meeting. They're placed in a format to where at any time a council member can remove any one of those items and place them in for an action and discussion item as part of the regular agenda. So just because they're listed in consent, if there is ever a question or concern that a council member has or something that has been raised to you by a resident that needs more clarification, you certainly have an opportunity, as Mayor Pro Tem has indicated, prior to the approval of that consent agenda to move an item to the actual working agenda. That's the only change as far as our business. These were items that were commonly done separately. And as you can recall, when we had maybe three or four sets of minutes, we were doing those individually. Now those are all done as part of one process. So we still will keep the rest of the agenda intact with the two public hearing opportunities, one for agenda items, one for general comments. Also, all new business or any other reports, the remaining portion of the agenda does not change at all. So hopefully that will help. And it will be a learning curve for all of us as we get through. So for the next, I would expect, couple of months, we'll be soliciting a little bit of prompts to the council members about the process again. And as everyone gets familiar with that, it'll become a little bit easier. So, and I thank you all for agreeing to work with this format. It's very common for municipalities to do this.
Any other questions for our city manager? Councilman Smetalski.
Just to follow up on that, and for an example, we removed one item from that consent agenda, and that is the appointments, and that will come up now after city attorney's reports, and it'll be debated in a separate vote.
This evening it will not. It was removed this evening because some of those appointments are actually appointments made by the mayor, and with him not being here this evening, we've removed those. But
well,
it could
completely off.
Yeah, it is completely right. Off. But it would be an example of something that if there was discussion, it would then be placed back on. But in this case, it was removed for the purpose of the mayor not being here this evening for his appointments.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other questions for city manager? Okay, if not, we'll move on to reports of the city attorney, Mr. Thomas.
If I could just jump on what Scott indicated, I would agree. Number one, a lot of municipalities are at this format. They've been there for some time as far as consent agendas. Obviously, tonight's a little bit of an aberration because we don't have a lot of business on the agenda, so it seems like we're going through it fairly quickly. But when we do have items of new business and whatnot, obviously we're not going to be in that same situation. With regard to the appointment issue that Councilman Svitolsky brought up, we had a discussion actually today, myself and Mr. Atkins. That may end up having to be a separate item because some of our appointments do not require the concurrence of council. Some of them are the mayor's appointments or the city manager's appointments, subject to confirmation by the mayor. There's all different factors at play. So that may be one of those items that we find is not beneficial to be under the consent agenda in the future. But the new format is very consistent with what you see in most municipalities today. Other than that, I have nothing further to report, and I'm happy to answer any questions you may have.
Real quick, Mr. Thomas, so mm-hmm. Is it technically, are we looking at a system that'll speed up the process, or is it just a different process?
Well, it's considered much more efficient because many of these items, such as approval of your disbursement list, virtually, very rarely do we have any debate or any questions. You can still ask questions before the consent agenda is approved. For instance, if you had a question specifically about an item on the disbursement list, that's appropriate time to ask Mr. Atkins on that. If you want to have a discussion about, let's say, a disbursement item, such as, hey, I object to bringing or paying this bill because of the contractor not doing any work, I don't know, whatever the case may be, that would be something that you would ask as a council person to have removed and put on the consent agenda action items, and it would be handled separately and voted on separately. But it's a more efficient means of going through city business, essentially.
And for the listening public too, a lot of times when council has their packets, we get our packets usually on a Friday or Saturday, whenever we can, you know, whenever they're able to get dropped off. A lot of times if we have questions, we contact the city manager, and he'll answer our questions. So a lot of these stuff is, you know, we're able to get these answers done before we come to the meeting. So if there's a question about the disbursement list and we want to know why certain monies were spent, we call our city manager so it don't take up the public's time during these meetings we have here. All right, are there any other questions for our city attorney? Okay, we'll move into the second hearing of the public. Second hearing of the public is will be for city business. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address. Address the chair. You are welcome to direct questions, input information, or express opinions to the council. Anyone using inappropriate language will be called out of order and will correct their language or leave the podium. Leave your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules will be called out of order by the chair. Anyone from the public wish to be heard in the second hearing of the public? Anyone from the public? Okay. Please state your name for the record.
My name is Mary Bartell. I live at 30444 Garfield, Roseville. And I appreciate you looking into Mr. Turi and the way he parks, but there is absolutely no problem during the day. It's between 3 and 4 o'clock and it's really bad. And their trucks are actually parked out on common road, stopping traffic, because they can't turn from the middle lane with all the cars there, you know. And the only problem is in the afternoon, and I hope that you're not going to let them build a parking lot over there between our houses.
There are no plans at this point, any parking lots. We've suggested some other property that's available out there, but there is nothing submitted at this point.
You know, Mr. Turi, twice at the city council meeting when he wanted to make his building bigger, said that all he would have to do is stagger his shifts and there would never be a problem. And now, if you could have him stagger the shifts, there would not be a problem. I mean, it's a real simple solution.
Well, I don't know if we legally have the ability to make them stagger the shifts, but we are working with him and we're looking at alternate options, and he has made a commitment to work with us. So.
And he is going to be able to go to park on the one side of the street still?
We're going to have additional dialogue with the council on some possible restrictions for parking. Right now that is an open public street and we cannot prohibit anyone from parking, so we're going to discuss some traffic control orders that would give us an ability to restrict parking.
It doesn't matter that he looked at all of us in the eye and lied to us about never parking on the street. Now, after a couple years, he's just going to be allowed to do it.
Mayor Pro Tem, can I answer?
Go right ahead.
Provide some input at least. At the time, Mr. Turi, with his attorney and with, well, I don't think his attorney was there, but his engineer came before the ZBA requesting a variance. Part of the variance issue was whether or not there's sufficient parking and the like. Ultimately, what happened is that day, Mr. Turi had, there was some discussion, and it was a back and forth discussion between ZBA and Mr. Turi and what was going on there. Mr. Turi had made some representations in, when these concerns were raised. Ultimately, though, what happened was Mr. Turi did not need a variance, and modifications were made to what he was designing and what he was building so as that he did not require a ZBA variance. Hence, there's nothing binding upon him whatsoever when it comes to that variance or that presentation on that particular evening. We did not grant him a variance. We did not provide him for a variance. We did not place any conditions on any variance because there's no variance that was ultimately approved by this council. So whether or not he made representations at that time, they really went to the wayside when in fact he didn't require a variance after coming before the board initially and then therefore modifying his plans so they conformed with the ordinance. So there's really nothing in our power from that perspective to force him to do certain things. Now, with that said, obviously, to accommodate any concerns that residents have, we have gone to Mr. Turi and all, as well as addressing the additional businesses in there to try to alleviate those concerns. And that's what we're doing. But to try to imply that there is a binding obligation on Mr. Turi to live by certain terms that are agreed upon is not entirely true. And I just want to make sure council's aware that that power is not in our hands, so to say. So I just want to make sure that we're not going down the wrong path on that issue.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Not much I can say about that.
Thank you, ma'am. Anyone else wish to be heard by the city council? Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Good evening, everyone. My name is James Singh. We have a small business on Gratiot, 11 and a half. We own the Chinese restaurant, Canton Inn.
Can you get your address?
And we've been in Roseville since, I think, 70 or 72. The bus stop used to be where Douglas and Taylor was. They had just some construction on the road, and they moved the bus stop to in front of our restaurant. There's been a lot of trash. There's a lot of loitering. People stand in our doorway. They come in and use our bathrooms. They come in and throw trash out when they don't want to throw it on the floor. And it's constant all day long. It's partially caused by the fast food chains across the street. The workers get off work, they come over, they wait for the bus, and that's what happens. The other problem is that they have some kind of government agency next to us, where Douglas and Taylor is. They bought that all out. They planted a whole row of trees up to our property on the sidewalk, and it blocks our sign. We have a post sign up high with lights on it, and you can't see the sign coming down the road from the street. So essentially, they blocked our parking lot. Besides, they've been parking in our parking lot. That's a different problem, you know, that we have to close the parking lot or do something like that. That's it.
Thank you, sir. Our city manager is taking copious notes here, and I'm sure he's going to be in contact you. With you when you get an answer about the bus stop.
Yes, I'll divide this up into a couple different pieces. We'll have some communications with SMART on the bus. We'll actually go out and do a physical look of what's happening there. And then I'll talk with Mr. Sexton in regards to the other issues dealing with the plantings, the property line, and those things, just to make sure that everything seems to be proper there.
And, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else wish to be heard by the City Council? Good evening, sir.
Good evening. David Chesney, 30440 Normal. I want to say that the fire department open house went very well, and with, I guess, the dedication of the Fallen Heroes Memorial at 4 o'clock on Sunday was very well. That fire department grant they got from FEMA for the 6 extra firefighters, yes, is definitely needed. Because you think there's 47,000 residents in Roseville, but you think about all the people that pass through on 12 Mile, 11 Mile, you know, the freeways, Gratiot, Grosbeck. You know, there's a lot of people pass through, and, you know, the fire department answers more than just fires. You know, they answer a lot of auto accidents. And some of the guys on the department were telling me that some of these car accidents are major smack accidents. You know, they're people, you know, go through a red light at a high rate of speed, and, you know, they're not all just fender benders, you know. And I want to bring up the address of 19140 Colorado. It's over between Gratiot and Tennessee. I drive the streets over there a lot, sometimes late at night, because I do it for Neighborhood Watch. I, you know, patrol my area quite a bit. I do a lot of the walk and watch program now. And that particular address, if you look at it from the street, the foundation's crumbling. And the house is actually leaning to one side like it's going to collapse. And when I drove down there one night, it looked like there was raccoons and possums coming up from under it, you know. So I shine a light over there, and I'm like, wow, this place. I understand that house has been like that for years. Mr. Sexton and the building department should look at actually having that house tore down, because I think that is definitely a safety hazard for the residents over on Colorado. And another thing I'd like to bring up, I hear that the city of East Point just passed an ordinance about these teenager school kids walking in the middle of the street, not moving for traffic, causing disruption. Yeah, East Point's writing tickets for that now. I think Roseville should too. you know, I've noticed more and more, this is getting to be more and more of a problem in our city. So, you know, that's what I want to bring up to, you know, it's a traffic hazard, you know. And sometimes they act like they don't want to move. You have to blow your own horn. My horn don't work. but still, you know, it's getting to be a problem. We need to look at enforcing that ordinance also. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else wish to be heard by the city council? Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Charlotte Boyd, 26658 Normandy. I threatened to be back in your meeting this fall, and I am back. So I understand that you have put on the agenda for November a request to have January declared Youth Art Month in Roseville. I have turned in petitions to the city manager, and he seemed very happy to have them, and I don't know if he's just happy because he's normally happy or he's just trying to placate me. But either way, he seems to be happy about having them. So we're looking forward to have that meeting of having you verify that, yes, we will make January Youth Art Month. I would like to make one comment about what our gentleman just discussed about the school kids in the street. It is not a new problem. In 68, when my kids were in junior high school, that long ago, they were walking in the streets then. They just walk in front of you. They just turn around, look at you. And if you honk your horn, some of them have scratched the cars as they go by. So it makes it a little more difficult problem of, you know, do you wait till they go to the side? Do you honk your horn? Or just what do you do? So I think it's a problem not just for the city, but for the school district. And I will be bringing it up at a Board of Education meeting too, so that they discuss it in the schools with the kids, because that's really where it'll have to be actually handled, because you can't have policemen on every corner when school is out. That's what I have to offer today.
Thank you, ma'am. Welcome back. Anyone else wish to be heard by the city council? If not, we'll move into items for discussion by city council. Councilman Switalski.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just have one thing. I had dinner at the Canton Inn after the Sadie Hawkins dinner dance back in 1972 or 3. Had a great time. I want to thank Lydia Krakowski for a wonderful evening and for all the time she helped me with my algebra homework, and I hope we can help you with your problems there. That's all I have.
Thank you. Thank you. Councilman Ayuto.
I'm going to say I ate at the Canton Inn too, but I don't have a backstory like that. thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. I have just a couple of rec authority information items. Saturday, October 19th, there is a snowmobile safety class. This is geared toward the ages of 12 to 17 year olds, and registration is $15. It runs from 9 a.m. till 4 p.m., but everyone is invited. So the 19th of October for a snowmobile safety class. On the 26th, Saturday the 26th of October, there's a mom-to-mom sale. And also at the Recreation Authority building. The Spooktacular Halloween Trick or Treat at Veterans Memorial Park is on again this year, and the wristbands will be $3. And I don't have the date for that, but that is coming up. There is a Rec Authority meeting this Thursday, a board meeting this Thursday at the Rec Authority building. Everyone is invited. We do invite you to come out and see what we're doing. One of the agenda items is the expansion of the existing building, where the latest plan is building a section is going to be dedicated to our seniors in the Senior Center program. There'll be a workout session, a gym area, a card playing area. It's really nice. If you want to hear more about it and see the plans, come to our meeting on Thursday. and we're building it out for our seniors, making it even more enjoyable. And finally, on November the 10th is our 35th annual Big Bird Run. If you've lived in Roseville for any length of time, you know about the Big Bird Run, and this is the 35th year that that's going to be running, and on November the 10th. That's all I have, Mayor Pro Tem. Thank you. Take care of each other.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Thank you. Councilman Udo, glad to hear you making special accommodations, you and Mickey, for the seniors at the East Point Roseville Rec Authority there. That's great. I had opportunity to attend the Roseville Fallen Heroes Memorial Dedication. Also, the Roseville Firefighters had a open house all on Sunday. And I want to give a special thanks to our firefighter, Bob Wooten. He was the chair and the founder of this committee, and everything came across real well. His vision came to reality. Many pair members were in attendance, as well as attendance tonight. Charlotte Void and many of the your members were there as well. So it was a good event, and I was glad to be part of it. That's all I have.
Thank you, Councilman Schmader. Councilman Hagerty.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. I, as Councilman Shoemaker said, I want to congratulate Bob Wooten and the entire committee that worked on that Fallen Heroes Memorial. It is a beautiful, beautiful addition to the city. It's sad that it has to be there. I hope and pray that we don't have to add any names to that, but they did a great job, and the weather cooperated. We didn't have any rain like they said we were going to, so it was a great addition. I'd like to give the citizens an update on the Rizzo recycling program. I have my recycle bin, and I love it. It's a great thing to put our recycling materials in. It's very easy to maneuver and roll it out to the street. You can recycle much more than you could with the little small bins. So it's a great thing, and I'm really happy with it. And I think that and you can also get rewards by using the recycling, and you can go online and they'll give you rewards for I think coupons and things for doing your recycling. So that's a great thing. And that's all I have, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilwoman McCartney.
Thank you. I just wanted to thank Roseville Community Schools, Roseville High School, for inviting us to their homecoming parade. It was a well-attended event. I work at the high school. The students were so involved with Spirit Week, and you can tell because other families came out to the parade on Saturday. We didn't do too good on the football. We lost on the game. Congratulations to our king and queen, Tyler Patron and Cassidy Martin. And just getting back to the question about jaywalking, the students at the high school in our media class did a little commercial, little skit about jaywalking, and we did mention to the students about crossing at the corner. So we are sending that message to our students, and we have crossing guards at Normal and Common, and I'm out in the street in the afternoon to cross the students too. So we are trying to, at least after school, keep it at a minimum. I can't guarantee when they get out farther from the school what happens, but we are informing the students about jaywalking. Use the corners and, you know, be careful with traffic. And that is all I have there.
Thank you. Hey, I would like to also echo some of the statements that Councilwoman McCartney made about the football game. The Roseville Boosters did a phenomenal job at the breakfast. That breakfast was well attended. They put a lot of work, a lot of time into it, and it was an awesome event. The parade, you know, we get the pleasure of walking down Common Road and handing out candy to the children and some of the families, and just seeing the smiles on their face was good for us, and it was good for Roseville. So, you know, it was a great day. The weather, I mean, it quit raining, I think, right when the parade started. And it was a long parade, too. It was they did a good job with that. Sir, from Canton Inn, we appreciate your business. Trust me. We every one of us up here have been to your establishment, you know, somewhere, sometime. And questions, concerns, always you can bring them to our city manager. Our city manager is more than willing to help you, you know, with any problems you have, or try to get some kind of answer to the questions you may have. So thank you for coming up here. But feel free, you can call him, his number, if you need it before you leave, you can get it from him. But thank you again for your business. You know, you've been here a long time, and we don't want to lose you. So, and then last I have is I'd like to wish a happy 75th birthday to my neighbor, Mr. Kenneth Lederman, in other words, known as Rocky. Turned 75 yesterday. He's lived in Roseville his whole life. And wish him a happy belated birthday. And on that, I am looking for a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Motion by Councilwoman Haggerty, supported by Councilwoman McCartney. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion. Anyone against? I don't think so. Our meeting is adjourned.